Chapter 2591. Battle of the Kings, 3. Yi Qingtong finally understood the true terror of the heavenly demon devouring bloodline. The other terrifying bloodlines that Yi Qingtong knew of would not even be able to raise their heads in front of the heavenly demon devouring bloodline. Perhaps not even the Lady in Green and the heavenly demon tribe themselves had expected the mutated heavenly demon devouring bloodline to be so terrifying. It could devour everything. Be it cultivation levels, bloodlines or anything else, they could all be forcibly absorbed by the heavenly demon devouring bloodline. Yi Qingtong knew that once knowledge of this bloodline was spread out, she would definitely be killed. No one would wish for the existence of the heavenly demon devouring bloodline in this world. They would not want their strength and bloodline would be swallowed by others. The heavenly demon devouring bloodline could be classified as a public enemy. It was a truly forbidden bloodline. Since ancient times, there were only a few forbidden bloodlines recorded in history books. The heavenly demon devouring bloodline was one of them. However, even the mutated heavenly demon devouring bloodline noted in the historical records was not as domineering as the one in Yi Qingtong's body. The battle within her body continued. The heart of the heavenly Tao seemed to be in a defensive state and did not release its full power. It seemed to have some concerns and was unwilling to waste the great Tao power. With the immense Tao power of the heart of the heavenly Tao, if it went all out, even the heavenly demon devouring bloodline might not have any chance of winning. Just a trace of the great Tao power unleashed by the heart of the heavenly Tao had nearly caused grievous injury to the heavenly demon devouring bloodline, who knew how much more Tao power was contained in the heart of the heavenly Tao. Yi Qingtong had already made up her mind that once the heavenly demon devouring bloodline lost, she would immediately take away the heavenly demon bloodline and not let anything happen to it. This bloodline was too important to Yi Qingtong and she could not afford to risk it. However, Yi Qingtong did not expect that after the two waves of attacks from the heavenly demon devouring bloodline, the heart of the heavenly Tao suddenly retreated into her heart, not giving the heavenly demon devouring bloodline any chance to continue devouring. No matter how the heavenly demon devouring bloodline provoked it, the heart of the heavenly Tao ignored it. It was as if the heart of the heavenly Tao was sentient and knew that the heavenly demon devouring bloodline would not dare to touch the heart. After a while, the heavenly demon devouring bloodline finally gave up. It waited for its master to give it the next order. Helpless, Yi Qingtong could only guide the heavenly demon devouring bloodline back the way it came. It didn't work. Yi Qingtong wiped the blood off the corner of her lips and mused. The heavenly demon devouring bloodline was indeed extremely domineering, but if the heart of the heavenly Tao had fought seriously, the heavenly demon devouring bloodline would not stand any advantage. Furthermore, the current heavenly demon devouring bloodline had not truly grown to its peak. Moreover, the heart of the heavenly Tao continued to hide. Yi Qingtong and the heavenly demon devouring bloodline could not do anything to it. However, although Yi Qingtong's idea did not succeed, she still gained a lot this time. The Tao energy devoured by the heavenly demon devouring bloodline was stronger than anything Yi Qingtong had encountered in the past. In the next second, Yi Qingtong's eyes turned completely white and even her pupils disappeared. Is this the power of the great Tao? Yi Qingtong muttered and pointed at the empty space in front of her. The sound of glass breaking rang out. Chapter 2592. Battle of the Kings. 4. At that moment, Yi Qingtong was completely expressionless. Her face was cold and her eyes were completely white. Coldness surrounded her as if she had already escaped the boundaries of humanity and morphed into the unknown. With that point of her finger, Yi Qingtong shattered the void and formed a finger-sized black hole. Soon after, the damaged black hole was quickly repaired and Yi Qingtong's snow-white eyes returned to normal. Yi Qingtong gasped lightly. The power of the great Tao alone was terrifying. It was as if she was standing at the top of the world and wanted to step on everything. It was so dangerous that it could even make her lose her mind. Having returned to normal now, Yi Qingtong was extremely shocked. The heavenly demon devouring bloodline only swallowed a trace of the great Tao power. But this sliver of energy was already so terrifying. If she could absorb all the great Tao power, what would happen then? However, it seemed that as long as the heart of the heavenly Tao remained hidden, she and the heavenly demon devouring bloodline did not have any good solution. Nevertheless, Yi Kington was not discouraged. No matter what, she had already succeeded somewhat. She had managed to snatch some of the Tao power, and this was enough to prove that it was possible. As for how she could snatch all the great Tao power from the heart of the heavenly Tao, she could only wait for an opportunity. Surely there should be a way to fulfill her wish in this era. Yi Kington checked her body again. The heavenly demon bloodline had also suffered a major blow just now. However, with the heavenly demon pearl, the heavenly demon devouring bloodline's recovery speed was also extremely fast, so Yi Kington did not need to worry too much. However, there was still something that Yi Kington did not understand. Why did the power of the heavenly demon bloodline and the heavenly demon pearl improve so much after she arrived in this era? If she had the chance, she had to study this matter. Perhaps there was still a chance for her heavenly demon pearl and the heavenly demon devouring bloodline to improve. Kington, I mean, Sister Yi. Just as Yi Kington was deep in thought, the young Feng Jiuyu shouted from outside and knocked on the door. Getting to her feet, Yi Kington walked over to open the door. Looking at the sweating Feng Jiuyu, she asked curiously, "Jiuyu, what's wrong, Sister Yi? Do you have time?" The young Feng Jiuyu wiped the sweat off his face and asked Yi Kington. Yi Kington smiled and said to Feng Jiuyu, "Your parents told me to look after you and not allow you to go to the middle of the mountain." Yi Kington thought that Feng Jiuyu wanted to drag her to Mount Zong to search for herbs again. "That's not it, Sister Yi. I don't want to go to the middle of the mountain," Feng Jiuyu explained. "Sister Yi, do you want to cultivate with us? As you're from the Mixed Heavens Holy Domain, your strength isn't that strong." Yi Kington, in the end, Yi Kington still agreed. It seemed she couldn't bring herself to reject this future legendary figure. "Sister Yi, I've reached a bottleneck, but I still have to work harder. We can cultivate together and become experts in the future. I don't want to see the Feng family continue to be bullied." The young Feng Jiuyu clenched his fists. "Jiuyu, did something happen?" Yi Kington frowned. Feng Jiuyu stared at Yi Kington and seemed to want to say something. In the end, he only shook his head. "Sister Yi, it's nothing. Let's cultivate together." Chapter 2593, Unparalleled, 1. Yi Kington could tell that there was something on Feng Jiuyu's mind. But since he was unwilling to say anything, she didn't want to probe. Soon after, Yi Kington followed Feng Jiuyu to the Feng family's training ground. The Feng family's training arena was quite spacious, but there were not many people. At a glance, apart from the few youths that Feng Jiuyu had introduced 2 days ago, there were also a few older martial artists. "Sister Yi, why are you here?" The young man who had praised Yi Kington for her good looks walked to Yi Kington's side and smiled. From Feng Jiuyu's introduction, Yi Kington knew that this young man's name was Feng Yuan. He was only 10 years old and was considered the youngest junior in the Feng family. Seeing Feng Yuan step forward, Yi Kington nodded and said to Feng Yuan, "I came to train with you guys." Yi Kington had a very good impression of these young men from the Feng family. These children from the Feng family were the most naive martial arts practitioners Yi Kington had ever seen, and did not have the maturity and shrewdness that came with age. At this stage, they were still considered innocent and pure. It was very relaxing for Yi Kington to be with these young men. "Sister Yi, really? Then, Sister Yi, can you teach me and Brother Jiuyu? We've already reached a bottleneck. Whether it be martial art skills or cultivation level, we can't improve further." Feng Yuan reached out to tug at Yi Kington's sleeve and stared at her with big watery eyes. "Yi Kington," before Yi Kington could speak, a young man looked over and walked over to Feng Jiuyu and Feng Yuan with an impassive expression. "Feng Jiuyu, Feng Yuan, who is she?" the man asked as his gaze landed on Yi Kington. "Brother Feng Kang, this is Sister Yi, a guest of our Feng family. She saved me when I was at Mount Zong and will be staying with our Feng family for a few days," Feng Jiuyu hurriedly explained to the young man. Feng Kang frowned as he said coldly, "Feng Jiuyu, who asked you to bring a stranger into our Feng family as a guest? Why is she staying here for a few days? Do you know her background?" Feng Jiuyu immediately nodded and said, "Brother Feng Kang, I do know, Sister Yi is a visitor from the mixed heavens holy domain to the divine venerate domain. The other young men looked at each other in dismay. They then looked disdainfully at Yi Kington. The mixed heavens holy domain was just a second-class domain with a backward martial arts culture. The condescension of a higher domain for a lower domain was the same ever since ancient times. The martial arts practitioners of the first domain's blue sky domain looked down on the mainland. Meanwhile, the second domain's mixed heavens holy domain had never taken the blue sky domain seriously. The divine venerate domain naturally did not take the mixed heavens holy domain seriously either. If the fourth domain had not been destroyed, the fourth domain probably would have looked down upon the third domain too. This sense of superiority, some were born with it, while others were nurtured. Such situations more or less existed in every domain. It was not rare, however. Yi Kington could not help shaking her head as she looked at Feng Kang and the rest. It was true that the mixed heavens holy domain could not be compared to the divine venerate domain. However, it was one thing for the top-notch experts of the divine venerate domain to look down on the martial arts culture of the mixed heavens holy domain. But these people were only at the most ordinary divine lord stage. Where did this sense of superiority come from? Chapter 2594, Unparalleled, 2. Feng Jiuyu looked at Feng Zhang unhappily. Don't say that about Sister Yi. She's my benefactor. Besides, my parents asked Sister Yi to stay here as a guest. Feng Zhang sneered. If anything happens, even your parents won't be able to bear the responsibility. Brother Feng Kang, Sister Yi is a girl. How can you say that? Feng Yuan said to Feng Kang. So what if she is a girl? There's no division between males and females in martial arts. Feng Jiuyu, immediately have this woman leave the Feng family. Otherwise, if anything happens, you and your parents won't be able to bear the consequences, Feng Zhang repeated. Before the young Feng Jiuyu could say anything, Feng Kang's gaze landed on Yi Kington. With a condescending look, he said coldly, Miss, the divine venerate domain is not a place you can enter as and when you please. I advise you to return to where you came from. It's not impossible to leap through the dragon gate, but you must be a true dragon first. A fish will forever be a fish and cannot transform into a dragon. Yi Kington smiled and did not say anything. What's happening? An old man suddenly appeared at the training grounds. He frowned at Feng Kang and the rest. Everyone was stunned when they saw the old man. Feng Kang and the others immediately stepped forward with respectful expressions and cupped their fists. Patriarch, Yi Kington sized up the old man. This old man was the current patriarch of the Feng family, and his cultivation level was at the peak of the seventh heaven level divine lord. In a small place like this, especially a small power like the Feng family, there were very few emperor-level experts. At least in the past decade or so, the Feng family had not had any emperor-level practitioners, not even any sub-emperors. From this, it could be seen that the cultivation level of this Feng family patriarch, who was at the seventh heaven level, was already considered not bad. Patriarch, Feng Jiuyu and his parents allowed an unknown person to stay in our Feng family estate. I find it to be more than a little inappropriate. Feng Kang immediately stepped forward and explained to the old man. The old man nodded and looked at Yi Kington before saying, I already know about this matter. Miss Yi saved Jiuyu and is a guest of the Feng family. Now that you're here, it's fine for you to stay for a few days. Seeing the patriarch's attitude, it was naturally inappropriate for Feng Kang to continue arguing. He could only nod and say, Patriarch, I understand. The Feng family patriarch looked at Yi Kington and said impassively, Miss Yi, the divine venerate domain is not like the mixed heavens holy domain. It is too dangerous. Moreover, the divine venerate domain's martial arts culture surpasses the mixed heavens holy domain. Even if you are considered an expert in the mixed heavens holy domain, it will be too dangerous for you in the divine venerate domain. Miss Yi, if you have seen enough, it's best not to stay in the divine venerate domain for too long. You should return to the mixed heavens holy domain as soon as possible. Feng Kang and several young martial arts practitioners looked at each other and smiled. Martial arts practitioners in the divine venerate domain like them completely looked down upon the martial arts culture of the mixed heavens holy domain. After all, there was a huge gap between these two domains. How strong could a practitioner from the mixed heaven's holy domain be? The patriarch ignored Yi Qingtong and said to Feng Jiuyu, Feng Yuan and the rest, train hard and don't fool around. The patriarch turned and left. After the patriarch left, Feng Yuan approached Yi Qingtong and tugged at the corner of her clothes. Sister Yi, I want to go out and play. Yuan, be a good boy. Practice first. When we're stronger, we can go play with Sister Yi then, said Feng Jiuyu. Hash. Chapter 2595. Unparalleled. 3. Feng Yuan nodded. All right. Although the minds of Feng Jiuyu and Feng Yuan were naive, their attacks were not light when they practiced their martial arts. Every single one of their moves contained the extremely powerful might of a divine lord. Yi Qingtong could not help but click her tongue. If she had such abilities when she was their age, wouldn't she be invincible now? It had to be said that the divine venerate domain's level of martial arts culture was indeed much higher than that of the mixed heaven's holy domain. Of course, this was only based on quantity, not quality. For example, there were immortal emperors in both the divine venerate domain and the mixed heaven's holy domain. The only difference was that the number of immortal emperors in the mixed heaven's holy domain could not be compared to the divine venerate domain. The divine venerate domain also had many more divine lord level practitioners than the mixed heaven's holy domain, but that did not mean that the divine lords of the latter were weaker. The martial art levels were the same. The only difference might be in the kind of skills one specialized in. Brother Jiuyu, your sword technique is much more powerful than before, Feng Yuan praised. Sigh, it's just so-so. I still can't do whatever I want. Feng Jiuyu seemed to be deep in thought. Yi Qingtong's lips curled up slightly when she heard Feng Jiuyu and Feng Yuan's conversation. These two little fellows were rather interesting. For some reason, Yi Qingtong felt that Feng Yuan's name was a little familiar, as if she had heard it somewhere before. However, she could not recall where. It seemed to have been recorded in history. Yi Qingtong sat at the side and watched as Feng Jiuyu and the rest focused on their cultivation. Meanwhile, she was deep in thought. She recalled the historical records she had read back then. In the historical records, there was a lot of information about Feng Jiuyu, but very few records about the Feng family, Feng Yuan, Yi Qingtong muttered softly. Before long, Yi Qingtong's expression changed slightly. If Yi Qingtong did not remember wrongly, the historical records stated that Feng Jiuyu had a very good playmate who was skilled in the Nine Heavens' Raging Aura. However, he was taken away by the heavenly demon tribe when he was very young and used as a blood sacrifice by them. However, Yi Qingtong did not know if that playmate of Feng Jiuyu was Feng Yuan. Almost instinctively, Yi Qingtong looked at Feng Yuan. Yuan, do you know the Nine Heavens' Raging Aura? Feng Jiuyu and Feng Yuan stopped in their tracks. Before Feng Yuan could say anything, Feng Jiuyu interrupted, Sister Yi, how did you know? Feng Yuan didn't use the Nine Heavens' Raging Aura just now. In our entire Feng family, only Feng Yuan knows this technique. This is Yuan's supreme martial arts ability. Oh, Yi Qingtong frowned slightly. Feng Yuan was the only person in the Feng family who knew the Nine Heavens' Raging Aura? If that was the case, Feng Yuan should be that playmate of Feng Jiuyu, who was captured and sacrificed by the heavenly demon tribe, right? Looking at Feng Yuan, Yi Qingtong felt rather conflicted. This innocent and pure youth's tragic fate had long been destined by history. No one could change it, and no one dared to change it. When Yi Qingtong returned to her senses, she saw that Feng Yuan was standing beside her and staring at her with his big, watery eyes. Sister Yi, are you homesick? Feng Yuan asked. Hash. Chapter 2596. Unparalleled. 4. Yi Qingtong looked at the jade pearl in Feng Yuan's small palm. For some reason, she felt very conflicted as she looked at Feng Yuan's innocent little face and asked, Yuan, why are you so good to me? Feng Yuan smiled shyly after hearing Yi Qingtong's words. Sister Yi, you saved Brother Jiuyu. Also, Sister Yi is so good looking. Sister Yi, when I become stronger in the future, I'll look for you in the mixed heaven's holy domain. Yi Qingtong was taken aback by Feng Yuan's words. When you grow up, You want to look for me in the mixed heaven's holy domain? Why, Feng Yuan rubbed his hands and looked at Yi Kington. His face flushed slightly. Sister Yi is so good looking. When I grow up, I want to go to the mixed heaven's holy domain and take Sister Yi's finger in marriage. Yi Kington, reaching out, Yi Kington accepted the jade pearl that Feng Yuan was offering her. All right, I will accept it. The young Feng Jiuyu quickly walked up and stared at Feng Yuan. He said with disdain, "What a fool. It should be to take her hand in marriage, not her finger." Feng Yuan tilted his head and pondered for a moment. He then nodded and said to Yi Kington again, "Yes, yes, yes. I'll grow up and become an expert. Then I'll go to the mixed heaven's holy domain and take Sister Yi's finger. No. Hand in marriage." Yi Kington could not help laughing when she saw Feng Yuan's expression. Perhaps, at this young age, Feng Yuan didn't even know what marriage was. He probably didn't understand the meaning of marriage. He was just being pure and open about what he liked. This was probably what real innocence looked like. In her two lifetimes, Yi Kington had experienced countless schemes and plots. She did not know how long it had been since she met a young boy like Feng Yuan. Fine, whatever. Look at how beautiful Sister Yi is. I wanted to marry her myself when I grow up. Forget it. I'll let you have her. Hurry up and cultivate to become stronger. If you're always so weak, who would want to marry you? Feng Jiuyu said seriously. Feng Yuan immediately nodded. Sister Yi, wait for me to become stronger first. I can't protect you right now. I'm too weak and can only defeat Brother Jiuyu. I can't defeat anyone else. Yi Kington, PFFT. Feng Jiuyu was unconvinced. So what? I can become stronger too. You won't be able to defeat me in the future. Before Feng Jiuyu could say anything, Feng Yuan's expression changed. Oh no, my parents told me to go to the market to buy things, but I forgot. With that, Feng Yuan pulled Yi Kington's sleeve. Sister Yi, can you come with me? All right. Yi Kington agreed without hesitation. She had never been to the market before. I'll go too. Sigh, this won't do. My parents won't let me go out today. They said that I can't go anywhere until my sword skills ascend another level. Feng Jiuyu burst his lips. Brother Jiuyu, stay at home then. We'll be no back soon. Wait for our return. I'll bring you something nice to eat, Feng Yuan said. With that, Yi Kington left the Feng family residence with Feng Yuan. The market here was different from ordinary markets. There were all sorts of items being sold here. Furthermore, there were all sorts of people here as well. When they arrived at the market, Feng Yuan widened his eyes and looked around. Before long, he returned to Yi Kington's side with two candied fruits. Sister Yi, this is for you. Chapter 2597, Unparalleled, 5. Yi Kington stared at the candied fruit in surprise. Sister Yi, this is very delicious. It can also increase your cultivation level, Feng Yuan explained to Yi Kington. Increase my cultivation level. Yi Kington smiled and accepted Feng Yuan's candied fruit without saying anything. The two of them walked forward. Along the way, Yi Kington realized that the market here was indeed extraordinary. Most of the people coming and going were at the Divine Lord level. Many stalls in the market were also opened by Divine Lord practitioners who sold all kinds of things, from unknown trinkets to rare herbs and even magical and martial arts techniques. They could be seen everywhere. Sister Yi, this place is very lively. It's somewhere where some major family clans and powerful cultivators gather. Some years ago, someone even bought a premium heaven-grade divine weapon from this market, Feng Yuan said to Yi Kington as he ate his candied fruit. Premium heaven-grade divine weapon. Yi Kington was amazed. As everyone knew, divine weapons were divided into four grades: heaven, earth, black and yellow. Yellow-grade weapons were the most common, while heaven-grade weapons were called true divine weapons. Heaven-grade divine weapons were rare enough, not to mention premium ones. If an elite emperor level practitioner obtained a premium heaven grade divine weapon, his combat strength would be invincible amongst his peers. It might even be possible for him to challenge an immortal emperor. It was truly unbelievable that a heaven grade divine weapon could appear in such a market. As an example, Yi Qingtan rarely used weapons now, as she just did not have any suitable weapons. Even superior Earth-grade weapons were rare. Without a suitable weapon, it was better not to use them. After a while, Feng Yuan walked to a stall and looked at Yi Qingtan with joy. Sister Yi, look, this is the Dragon 9000 herb, a rare herb that can improve a paragon's skill. Yi Qingtan walked forward and examined it. She indeed could not recognize this herb. Many rare herbs in this era had been extinct for a long time by Yi Qingtan's era. There were not even any records of many extinct herbs in history. How could Yi Qingtan recognize them? It can improve a paragon's skill. Yi Qingtan was deep in thought. In her era, she had never heard of any rare medicinal herbs that could improve a paragon's skill. This Dragon 9000 herb could improve a paragon's skill, but she wondered if could improve an ultimate origin skill. After a round of haggling, Feng Yuan finally managed to purchase the Dragon 9000 herb from the stall owner. Just as the two of them were about to leave, Yi Qingtan inadvertently glanced at an ordinary small wooden box on the stall. However, the moment Yi Qingtan looked at it, the heavenly demon pearl in her body had an inexplicable reaction and started to circulate rapidly in her body. Sensing the abnormality of the heavenly demon pearl, Yi Qingtan's expression shifted. She could not help looking more closely at the small wooden box. However, the more Yi Qingtan examined it, the faster the heavenly demon pearl circulated. This is strange. Yi Qingtan stared at the small wooden box as she sensed the abnormality of the heavenly demon pearl in her body. It was the first time Yi Qingtan experienced something like this. It had never happened before. Chapter 2598, Unparalleled, 6. Yi Qingtan crouched down and looked at the stall owner. The stall owner was a middle-aged man whose cultivation level was around the fourth heaven level divine lord. From his appearance, he seemed to be an itinerant cultivator. Miss, what are you interested in? Tell me. The middle-aged man smiled when he saw that Yi Qingtan was interested in the items in his stall. That small wooden box is rather interesting. What is it? Yi Qingtan pointed at the small wooden box in the stall. The middle-aged man was taken aback. This? The middle-aged man picked up the wooden box. Yes. Yi Qingtan nodded slightly. It was this small wooden box that had some mysterious connection with the heavenly demon pearl in her body. Holding the wooden box, the middle-aged man sized up Yi Qingtan. In fact, the middle-aged man did not know what this wooden box was either. He advertently picked it up a few days ago at the periphery of a certain holy land popular with treasure hunters. The middle-aged man thought it was a treasure, but in the end, he discovered that other than being incomparably hard and indestructible, this small wooden box was completely useless. There were no energy fluctuations or any such thing. The only amazing thing was that it was so hard that it made one's hair stand on end. Even if the middle-aged man used the full strength of a divine lord, he was still unable to cause the slightest damage to this small wooden box. It was also because of this that the middle-aged man placed the small wooden box in the stall. During this period of time, many martial arts practitioners were curious and asked him about it. However, the middle-aged man did not know the origins of the small wooden box. He could not explain it, so no one was willing to buy it. At that moment, the middle-aged man saw that Yi Qingtan seemed to be interested in the small wooden box. His eyes darted around and he said seriously, "Little girl, you know your stuff. You can tell that my small wooden box is extraordinary." Yi Qingtan was stunned. When did she say that this small wooden box was extraordinary? She was just asking a casual question. "Miss, to be honest, this item belongs to my great-great-great-great-grandfather. It has existed since a long time ago. It is said that it is my great-great-great-great-grandfather's Dharma treasure. Unfortunately, although this Dharma treasure has been passed down, the method to use it has been lost." The middle-aged man stared at Yi Qingtan. Yi Qingtan could not help chuckling when she heard the middle-aged man's narration. This person's ability to lie through his teeth was indeed extraordinary. If this wooden box was really as the middle-aged man had said, would he have placed it in his stall? "Uncle, someone asked you about this small wooden box earlier. Didn't you say that you didn't know? Why has it become your great-great-great-great-grandfather's treasure now?" Feng Yuan looked at the middle-aged man curiously. "Yi Qingtan, the middle-aged man. Ahem, kid, I just didn't want to sell it to them and so lied to them. How could I not know the origin of my things? Miss, if you really want it, give me a price. I feel that you are somewhat fated with my late great-great-great-great-grandfather. Perhaps you will be able to activate this Dharma treasure. The middle-aged man stared at Yi Kington. Before Yi Kington could reply, the middle-aged man continued, Miss, do you want it? I can sell it to you at a cheaper price. Chapter 2599, Unparalleled, 7, Let me consider it. Yi Kington smiled at the middle-aged man. Miss, listen to me. This is definitely a good item. Don't listen to this kid's nonsense. I didn't just randomly pick it up from the streets. The middle-aged man hurriedly urged. Seeing that Yi Kington did not speak, the middle-aged man threw the small wooden box on the ground. Looking at the intact wooden box, he said, How is it? I didn't lie to you, right? It's really a rare Dharma treasure. Miss, you are fated with it. You must have it. Will you give it to me for free then? Yi Kington asked the middle-aged man after a moment of silence. The middle-aged man was stunned by Yi Kington's words. He looked at Yi Kington in disbelief. I say, Miss, you are young, beautiful and wearing extraordinary clothes. How can you have the cheek to let a poor trader who lives on the edge of life and death give you something for free? Yi Kington smiled and said, I don't have money. The burning gaze in the middle-aged man's eyes dissipated instantly. If you don't have money, why are you talking so much to me then? Yi Kington was dumbstruck. Didn't she just ask a casual question? He was the one who kept blabbering on and on. Although I don't have money, I have goods. Do you want to exchange? Yi Kington smiled at the middle-aged man. Yi Kington was not lying. She indeed did not have money. Moreover, the currency of her era was completely different from that of this era. However, she had many other things besides money. Goods. The middle-aged man glanced at Yi Kington. What goods? Tell me. Elixirs. How about that? Yi Kington asked. As she spoke, Yi Kington took out an elixir from her space ring. Yi Kington had refined this elixir at the Wailing Well. It was more than enough for her to exchange for a lousy small box, even though this elixir was not considered very valuable. This, the middle-aged man and even Feng Jiu's eyes widened at the sight of Yi Kington's elixir. Yi Kington was rather puzzled by their expressions. Her elixir was very ordinary, especially to a Divine Lord level practitioner. It should not be considered anything special. There was no need to look so surprised. This. Miss, can you let me take a look? The middle-aged man looked very eager. Take it. Yi Kington casually threw the elixir to the middle-aged man. The middle-aged man was quick to react. He grabbed the elixir with caution. After examining it for a long time, the middle-aged man could not help but look at Yi Kington in shock. It's actually a real elixir. Yi Kington was dumbstruck. Did he really have to say that? She was a powerful figure who was close to being a sub-emperor. Why would she need to fake such an ordinary elixir? Miss, you are not a student of the Great Immortal Temple, right? The middle-aged man's body trembled slightly and his expression changed as he looked at Yi Kington. Great Immortal Temple? Yi Kington fell into deep thought. She seemed to have read about this in the historical records before. It sounded a little familiar, but she could not recall it at the moment. I'm not. Yi Kington shook her head. Why are you so shocked? It's just an elixir. Just an elixir. The middle-aged man widened his eyes in disbelief. I say, young lady, you really know how to crack jokes. Do you know what a completed elixir is? This is the second time in my life that I've seen a completed elixir. Hash. Chapter 2600, Unparalleled, 8. At the side, Feng Yu-I tugged Yi Kington's sleeve as he stared at her with his big watery eyes. Sister Yi, this is the first time I'm seeing a completed elixir too. Looking at the middle-aged man and Feng Yu-I, Yi Kington frowned slightly. She felt a little baffled. One had never seen a completed elixir before, while the other had only seen one other in his entire life. Seriously? Yuan, you have never seen an elixir before? Yi Kington blurted out. Feng Yuan shook his head and said, Sister Yi, number. Elixirs have only been recently invented by the Great Immortal Temple. Yi Kington was stunned. What Feng Yuan meant was that in this era, elixirs had just been invented. Before this, No one understood the concept of elixirs. Yi Qingtong understood everything now. It was no wonder that Feng Jiuyu had taken such a huge risk to find herbs in the middle of the mountain instead of just getting elixirs. All of this was because in this era, elixirs had just been invented, and it was still using the most traditional pill refinement method. There was no so-called palm flame and no such thing as a perfect grade elixir. Everything was still in the crude initial stages, the most inferior grades of elixirs. Yi Qingtong calmed herself down and looked at the middle-aged man. "What do you think? Do you want to exchange?" The middle-aged man nodded profusely and carefully scanned his surroundings. When he realized that no one was paying attention to his elixir, he carefully kept it as if it was his family heirloom. He looked at Yi Qingtong and said hurriedly, "Exchange." "Miss, I just said that you are definitely not an ordinary person. Although your completed elixir is extremely precious, my item is my great-great-great-great-grandfather's peerless Dharma treasure. You are definitely not at a disadvantage." "Don't worry." Yi Qingtong did not waste any time talking. She took the small wooden box and threw it into her space ring. "Let's go." After putting away the small wooden box, Yi Qingtong looked at Feng Yuan and smiled. "Okay." Feng Yuan nodded and pulled Yi Qingtong's sleeve as they walked forward. Meanwhile, somewhere in the market, two men in black robes never took their eyes off Feng Yuan. "That young man is very extraordinary," one of the black-robed men said. "Indeed, he has a divine aura and is very suitable as an offering. He should be one of the youths from the Feng family." At that moment, Yi Qingtong's eyes flickered as she inadvertently scanned behind her. As for the two black-robed men, they had already disappeared. "Sister Yi, what's wrong?" Feng Yuan asked Yi Qingtong when he saw that she had stopped moving. Yi Qingtong smiled at Feng Yuan. "It's nothing."
"Yuan, have you finished buying what you need?"
"Let's go home, Sister Yi. I've bought everything I need."
"Sister Yi,
don't you want to shop a little longer?" Feng Yuan said.
"No, I'm a little tired today.
Let's go back."
Yi Qingtong smiled.
"All right."
Feng Yuan nodded and pulled Yi Qingtong toward the back. He went to buy two more sticks of candied fruit and handed one to Yi Qingtong. Yi Qingtong felt increasingly conflicted after receiving the candied fruit. Was history going to repeat itself? But she was just a passerby of this era. Hash.